One of the most intriguing scenes in Prometheus was the conversation between David and one of the engineers, creators of humanity. In this video, I'm going to translate the extended version of the dialogue from the deleted scene, which is slightly longer than the theatrical cut. Be sure to subscribe if you're new to the channel, and sorry if I speak too slow, I noticed many of you guys commented about this. I guess that's just my normal pace, but I'm going to try to speed it up a little bit. Screenwriter Damon Lindelof admitted in an interview that the film originally had subtitles for this scene, but Ridley Scott felt really strongly about not including them. So the dialogue in Prometheus isn't subtitled, so it's not clear what exactly David said to the engineer and what was his response. And given that David doesn't seem to value human life, many people thought that he must have said something extremely offensive that would trigger the engineer to start killing people. But it's actually not true, and surprisingly, David asked what Mr. Weyland wanted. So let's get to the translation. David talks to the engineer in Proto-Indo-European, an ancient language, ancestor of the Indo-European languages such as Spanish, English, German, Bulgarian, and others. It is probably one of the oldest languages in human history. And if you remember, at the beginning in Prometheus, David studies Proto-Indo-European with a holographic tutor. Actually, the tutor on the hologram is a real-life linguist, Dr. Anil Bilto from London's Language Center. He was hired by Ridley to teach Michael Fassbender and the actor who played the engineer some lines on Proto-Indo-European. The deleted scene starts with Weyland asking if the engineer is alive. David says absolutely. When the engineer wakes up from the cryosleep, David starts talking to him and his first line translates as, "We came here from Earth and these people believe you invited them here." Then the engineer steps out from a cryosleep chamber and responds, "Why are you here?" Then Weyland asks, "What did he say?" Shaw interrupts the conversation, trying to ask about the cargo and what was their mission, but the guy hits her. Then David says exactly what Weyland requested, which translates as follows. "This man is here because he doesn't want to die. He believes you can give him more life." The engineer responds, "What this man has done that makes him so great that he deserves more life?" And Weyland steps into the conversation saying that, "You see this man," pointing at David, "my company built him from nothing. I made him in my own image so he would be perfect, so he would never fail. I deserve this because you and I, we are superior, we are creators, we are gods, and gods never die." A few seconds after that, the engineer rips off David's head and proceeds on finishing his mission. This scene is actually very similar to another movie directed by Ridley Scott, Blade Runner of 1982, where an android kills one of the main characters almost in the same way by cracking one's neck. On this shot, Weyland almost touches the engineer with his forefinger, which is a reference to the famous Michelangelo's painting, The Creation of Adam, where God almost touches his creation, Adam. The last interesting detail that I want to mention is that maybe the engineer saw how one of the Weyland's men hit Shaw, and he realized that even after 2,000 years, humanity did not change and is still a violent and dangerous species, and he decided to accomplish his original mission. Engineers viewed humans as a mistake and a failed experiment, and the encounter with them after awakening proved it once again. Also, the engineer notices that humans evolved way more than they expected and now capable of building highly advanced androids and traveling to distant stars. Technological progress would make humans even more dangerous for themselves, engineers, and probably other species. So that's a possible reason why the engineer proceeds to destroy humanity after 2,000 years of cryosleep. What do you guys think about the dialogue with the engineer, and did it really matter what David said to him, or the engineer would start killing people anyway? Let me know what you think. And thank you guys for watching, I really appreciate that. Hit the like button if you enjoyed the video, and be sure to subscribe to my channel for more alien content and other videos about movies.